Welcome back to The Great Escape. Now, ancient forts, unknown beaches, few tourists. And the only way to get to these places is from Bombay. Sounds impossible, right? Well, join The Great Escape team as they set out on a discovery.
Trains, cars and buses, couch potatoes and TV. That's what the city does to you.
The big cities are too big. There isn't even place for a fig. The traffic's a snail with a long tail. What do you think I am, a poet? How can anyone be fit in this city? I need to have a break. I have to get fit.
How often have exercise schedules started with a bang and ended with a whimper? Well, how's this for ambition? A cycle ride down the coast, starting from Kihim in the south of Bombay, I plan to make my way down to wherever the next few days takes me. Kihim, a quiet little seaside village, the odd boats in the distance, children playing with crabs, and me. Well, it can't be that quiet with me around.
Can you still hear it? I mean the city. But here we are at last. Open spaces, fresh air. I think I'm ready to go.
A one-hour ferry ride from Bombay to Mandwa, a short cycle ride, and Kihim gets you. I think it's time for my first break. Or maybe not. Remember? Determination. One step at a time.
Ah, fish. Fish brought me to this fishing village, which they say is brimming with activity. But where are they? And if this is their idea of activity, I could stay here forever. This is the famous Bombay Duck Walk. At least the flies around here are buzzing with activity. Hey, Babu! Hey, Babu!
I finally solved the mystery of the missing fishermen. The Ganesh festival is on. That means hardly any fishing for 10 days as a mark of respect to Ganesh. The time is spent to dry fish, to pair nets and boats, and catch up with family and friends.
Hey! Iska kanta hai isme. Kanta hai isme. पहले क्यों नहीं बोला कि कांटा इसमें वो चैप्स डाइड फॉर द कॉज
फिटनेस इज रियली हार्ड वर्क एंड आई एम टायर्ड सनबर्न्ट एंड सो आई जस्ट कांट वेट टू हिट द शावर्स. One thing I was unprepared for was this. Sunburn. Now I know what fried eggs feel like. Anti-rust drive.
The trip from Kihim to Alibag is not too long, but I felt quite stiff the next morning. Nothing like a little exercise to get the juices flowing and the heart pumping. If you've grown as unfit as I have and have begun an exercise regime, you'll know how tough it is to get restarted. I need a break. A kind of lunch break. But first, it's time to see Chol, an ancient Portuguese ruin that has almost merged with the countryside.
Once upon a time, this place was infested with Portuguese, but now not even the locals know about it. It's kind of spooky, but that's to be expected after 400 years of wreck, ruin, and neglect.
All that's left of this fort is an old chapel, a watch house, and ghosts of the past. The area inside is used to grow coconut trees. Trade possibilities, destiny, adventure, and faith. That's what inspired the Portuguese to risk life and limb and voyage to distant shores, so that 400 years later, people like me could ponder over their actions. History will get your mind off food for a while. Onwards, towards Murud, a good 30 kilometers and at least a couple of snack breaks away.
Since I've come here, all I've heard about is Ganpati, Ganpati, Ganpati. And now I have a sneaky feeling I'm going to learn more about it.
Today, the last day of the festival is when Ganpati is immersed in the sea. Although tired, I was soon sucked into the excitement, and before I knew it,
the scene of Ganpati, the morning after.
The magic that had captured me the night before seems to have vanished. Fragments of firecrackers littered the beach, a mute reminder of the festivities of the night before. For the fishermen, their holiday was over. It was another day at the office.
Bhai sahab, machhi hai kya? Aaka dekh sakte hain? ये कितना 20 किलो होगा ये अकेला हम खा लेगा
ये हलवा ये देख
ये हलवा
हां ये काला पापलेट बोलते हैं उसको
ये बहुत टेस्टी होगा ना
हां बहुत टेस्टी
इससे बड़ा भी आता है
बड़ा बड़ा
वो उसको उठाने में बहुत मुश्किल होता होगा ना कितना आदमी काम करता है एक बार में
14
आदमी है
हां
Hey, Jutmu, egg machi thali.
I think the stomach won the battle today.
It's hard not to let this sleepy little town grow on you. The temptation to lie under a coconut tree and catch 40 winks is ever so attractive. I have to keep telling myself, breathe, exercise, relax. I think I'm getting the hang of things. There's nothing quite as relaxing as a quiet ride out to sea. The sound of the water slapping the boat, the wind fluttering the sails, makes you forget where you are.
I am the king of the temple.
Built in the 15th century by the Siddis, a group of Abyssinian sailors, Janjira stands impressively out at sea. It took a little over 11 generations to see the fort finally completed. They did a pretty thorough job. Freshwater pools, a seven-storied palace, and secret exits in case the fort was attacked. The fort, overgrown with weeds, makes it difficult for you to explore. The watchman's view is easy to find. Standing here, looking out to sea, you find yourself being transported to many different places at once.
Ganpati Papa Moria, 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 Ganpati Papa Moria, Moria Re.
Well, I've had a fun-filled 3 days. I don't think I've lost much weight, but I feel fitter, and I've had a good break. I'm all ready to face life in the city again. Oh my God, I've still got my journey back. Just kidding.